Welcome to the Hour of Harvest. It is great to have you with us as we worship the Lord. Sit back and enjoy as we share the good news of the gospel. We invite you to participate along with us as we sing songs of praise, read the Bible, and pray for those in need. The Hour of Harvest prayer team is standing by to take your prayer requests, praise reports, and lead souls to the Lord. You may call us at 606-464-4250 at any time during this program. May this program be a place where you feel accepted, loved, forgiven, and encouraged in the Lord. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls with the unconditional love of Christ from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. From our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
All righty. Well, welcome everybody to WLJC tonight, Hour of Harvest. I'm thankful to be asked to be here to sit in to host tonight for Sister Margaret. Do want to ask that everyone continue to pray for her. I know she's doing better and getting strengthened each and every day, but we want to continue to pray for her that she will get her complete healing back and get back here in this chair where she loves to be. I told them, Sister Margaret, I don't know if they got the right person in your chair tonight or not, but I'm going to try to hold it down and do the best I can. But we've got a great program for you tonight. Great singers. We already got to hear them getting ready and warmed up here, and I know they've got some great songs to bless you with tonight, and so we just want to go ahead and share the word of the Lord with you and get out of the way and give them plenty of time to sing this evening, because I'm looking forward to hearing them and pray that they'll be a blessing to you. Listen, if you're lost tonight, listen to the words of the songs, listen to the word of God, and let God speak to your heart. If you need encouragement, that's why we're here. This is ministry, folks. This is not entertainment. We're here to bring the word of God and to bring you some help and hope through this ministry. And I believe there's people tuned in tonight who needs God to move in their lives. And that's why I'm here. I believe in this ministry, and I believe that there are people getting touched and helped, and I don't think tonight's going to be any different. So you need to pray. We've got people upstairs that's waiting and just ready to talk to you. You can give them a call, and the number will be on the screen there. You can give them a call. They'll pray with you, and we'll just have a really good night praying somebody gets saved. Go to read the Word of God for you right now. I want to go to the book of Psalm 147. I was trying to find a place where maybe I would cut it off, but I didn't find no place where I wanted to, so I'm just going to read the whole thing. Psalm 147, 1 through 20 says, "Praise ye the Lord, for it is good to sing praises unto our God, for it is pleasant, and praise is comely." Ain't that good? It said, "The Lord doth build up Jerusalem. He gathereth together the outcast of Israel." Lord, I thank God that He loves the outcast. "He helpeth the broken in heart and bindeth up their wounds." Amen. "He telleth the number of the stars. He calleth them all by their names. Great is our Lord, and great and of great power. His understanding is infinite. The Lord lifteth up the meek. He casteth the wicked down to the ground. Sing unto the Lord with thanksgiving, sing and praise upon the harp with our God, who covereth the heaven with clouds, who prepareth the rain for the earth, who maketh grass to grow upon the mountains. He giveth to the beast his food, and to the young ravens which cry. He delighteth not in the strength of the house. He taketh not pleasure in the legs of the horse. He taketh not pleasure in the legs of man. The Lord taketh pleasure in them that fear Him." Think about that. "And those that hope in His mercy." That brings pleasure to God when we will come to Him in our most humble state, in our most miserable states, in our most tormented states, in our most vile states. When we will come to Him and fear Him, it brings pleasure to the Lord when we show Him that we hope in His mercy. "Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise thy God, O Zion. For He hath strengthened the bars of thy gates. He hath blessed thy children within thee. He maketh peace in thy borders and filleth thee with the finest of wheat. He sendeth forth His commandment upon the earth. His word runneth very swiftly. He giveth snow like wool. He scattereth the hoarfrost like ashes. He casteth forth His ice like morsels. Who can stand before His cold?" I like this. "He sendeth out His word and melteth them. He causeth His wind to blow and water waters to fly. He showeth his word unto judgment, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He hath not dealt so with any nation, and as for his judgments, they have not known them. Praise ye the Lord. So this psalm started out, I know it said a lot of stuff. It talked about the power of the Lord, his love to those who are outcast, his mercy to those who are hurting, his willingness to bind up our broken heart and to heal our wounds. But I want to bring our attention back tonight to the fact that it said, praise ye the Lord, for it is good to sing praises unto our God. It is pleasant and praise is comely. And that's what we've come to do tonight, is to praise the Lord in song and the Word of God. And we've got a great group that's going to be with us tonight. I'll tell you a little more about them in a second. I'll share a few prayer requests, and then I'll tell you about the group. And we're going to have prayer and just turn them loose to sing. Want to give them all the time we can to minister tonight. They've drove a long way to be here. But we have a lady from Campton, Kentucky, who needs the Lord to heal her. We're going to pray that God will do that. We also have a gentleman that called in and is praying that he and his family will be saved. Amen. Brother, I hope you're watching tonight, and I hope you've got your family gathered around. I believe something will be done, and the Spirit will move in your heart, and you can be saved tonight. Just call right in. Somebody will pray with you and lead you to the Lord. Got somebody here, Goldie in Mount Sterling, wanting prayer for her husband and all that are sick. Morgan from Morgan County, got a lady that has an unspoken request. From Somerset, Catherine is needing prayer for some health problems. From Montgomery County, Tammy is needing some physical healing as well in her body. I pray the Lord will touch you. And here's somebody from Somerset as well that's called in a pledge to support the station. We appreciate that. So we're going to go ahead and pray, and then I'll introduce these gentlemen and turn them loose, let them get some time in singing and ministering the Word of God tonight. So let's just go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we're so thankful for the opportunity to be in your house, God, to be here in this studio knowing that your presence is here, that your anointing is here, your help is here, God. And Lord, I just pray over these men tonight, Lord, that you would touch them, your anointing would be upon them, that they could minister the Word through song, God, to be an encouragement, Lord. Just pray that they would be a help to people tonight. And God, we pray for these requests that's already been called in. Many people needing a healing in their body, Lord. And by your stripes we're healed in the name of Jesus. And God, tonight let everything be done decent and in order, and to uplift your name, pour your blessing out on it, and let there be good things come from this service in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen, amen. All right. So we've got with us tonight from over in Monticello, Kentucky, the Fall Creek Boys. I know they're no strangers to the viewing audience here at WLJC, so they're going to bless your heart tonight. If you want to, they do have some CDs. If you'd like to get a CD or talk to them about booking or anything like that, you can contact Jordan Burks. His telephone number is 606-307-0257. They are from the Fall Creek Baptist Church over there. So let's enjoy the music tonight, and I pray you are blessed with the Fall Creek Boys.
Anybody else ever forgets? I do. I forgot how to kick that off, brother.
It's all right.
Well, I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin, and I would not let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like an angel in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. When I saw the light, I saw the light. No more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrows inside. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. Well, have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in His grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood?
In the blood.
In the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they whiter than snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Well, now some bright morning, when this life is over, I'll fly away in the morning. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
Sometimes, what is that old saying is, best laid plans, oh mice and men. I had a whole new kickoff to just kick that off with, and like everything else in my life, when you got three kids, you tend to forget things, amen? But anyway, it's been a long drive up here, and forgot what I was doing there. If I hadn't said anything, they might not have known it, would
that's
they?
Right.
But I did it anyway, that's okay. But we're going to do one for you now that I hope that you enjoy. It's one of the most requested ones we do. It's called Go Rest High on That Mountain. Amen. And features brother Stephen. I'll get you right in a minute, Stephen. Stephen Denny over there. You'll enjoy him. Listen to the words of the song. Only you could know the pain. You weren't afraid to face the devil. You were no stranger to the rain. So go rest high on that mountain. Son, your work on earth is done. And go to heaven to shout. Look for the Father and the Son.
day you left us. We gathered round your grave to grieve. Wish I could see the angels' faces.
Amen.
When they hear your sweet voice sing, so go rest high on that mountain, 'cause son, your work on earth is done. And go to heaven and shout, look for the Father and the Son.
Play me one more, Steve.
Does a fantastic job on that guitar. To me, and this is just my opinion, and I think very highly of it, but I think he's, it's a joke, I think he's the best guitar player I've ever heard. I really do, and I don't know if anybody would ever want to prove me wrong, but Stephen, I'm proud to be your brother in Christ, amen, and I thank
Absolutely.
God for that.
Same back at you, my friend.
Amen, and this guy sitting next to me, and I'll tell you, I've told him a million times, the best bass player I ever had, or ever heard, and I taught him everything he knows, right?
Amen. Right.
Now, Jay has taught me more about playing the bass, and he's a wonderful pastor, dear friend, same as Stephen, and I'm the old man of the group that just happens to be the youngest, right? And anyway, I'm the one that's been around the most. Back about 15 years ago is when we first started coming over. I think they still had VHS cassettes, I believe. I believe they just went over to DVDs. And the youngins here are looking at me like I'm crazy.
You're pretty old.
I'm pretty old. I'm an antique. Got to be careful with that one. But anyway, it is always a thrill and a pleasure and an honor to be here. There we are. And I want to just say tonight, we have a good time in the Lord, and I joke and I kid and I cut up and I carry on. But the main focus and the main purpose tonight is about Jesus Christ.
Amen, amen.
And you thinking about your soul. You think right now, well, where would I spend eternity? If I left the walls of this life right now, where would I go? I want you to think about that over the next how many ever minutes that we've got left. And I want you to, by the end of this program, I want you to ask yourself that question throughout tonight. And at the end of this service, if you think to yourself, I don't know where I'd go, then you need to make a phone call right up here and talk to somebody who can lead you in the right direction, because you need Jesus tonight. And I thank God for a praying mama. I thank God for a praying daddy. And I sure thank God for praying people. What a prayer can do.
Amen. It's always good to be back here tonight. And I want to challenge you tonight that if you don't know the Lord as your personal Savior, that you consider it. Friends, I tell you, life's too short and eternity is forever. If you were to go and be with the Lord tonight, I pray that you're ready and that your soul is saved tonight. It's the most important decision you'll ever make. Pray that maybe something we'd say or sing here tonight will get you thinking about that. Maybe you have friends or loved ones that may be lost and undone tonight. And so we hope that someone will hear the gospel tonight. What a prayer can do.
A baby fought for its life the whole night through. All hope was gone. How the tears fell, not just a few. But there's my grandma over in the corner. She knew the one to pull me through. And I'm still alive for what a prayer. Prayer can do, Sam Jake.
Well, it's moved mountains, parted rivers, brought the dead to life again. I've called upon an old prayer warrior a time or two. If you're in trouble, I'll go down on my just amazing what a prayer can do.
There was a king. Got a letter, a mighty army without number. He spread it out there for the Lord to take a view. That there was the prophet, amen, and just one angel. The devil's army met its doom. It's just amazing what a prayer can do. Oh, tell us about it, Jay.
Well, it's moved mountains, parted rivers, brought the dead to life again. I've called upon an old prayer warrior a time or two. If you're in trouble,
praying mama and daddy tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Thankful for that tonight. Amen.
Amen. Thank God for that. What a prayer can do. Amen. Folks used to ask us many years ago, we've been traveling singing together for a long time, and they say, many moons, and they say, what do you come for? I say, well, for two things. Number one, we go for the Lord. That's number one. And number two, we go for the fried chicken. Amen. Amen. We love fried chicken, so we like it so much we wrote a song about it, and it goes a little something like this in the key of E-flat. I don't know why somebody wrote it in that key, but it's all right. That sound about right? All right. Well, we sure do like it fried chicken, Pastor. Believe it or not, it's sure do like it fried chicken, man. We're famous crispy, we don't mind, just tell us where to get in line. We sure do like that fried chicken, Lord. Went out fried chicken, that's a special treat. And the more you make, well, the more we'll eat. And sometimes we can't get ourselves to stop. Well, most folks make it for the church meat, and we get to take home the ones that they don't eat, and we store it down in our safety deposit box. Sang it, boys. Oh, we sure do like that fried chicken, Pastor. Oh, we sure do like that fried chicken, man. Famous Crispy, we don't mind, just tell us where to go get in line. We sure do like that fried chicken, Lord. Now the ones without bones just make things worse, cause it makes them easier to eat than first. And I gotta admit, they're impossible to resist. Most folks make it for the church meat, and we get to take home the ones that they don't eat, and we store it down our safety deposit box. It's our bellies. Oh, we sure do like that fried chicken, Pastor. We sure do like that fried chicken, man. Famous Crispy, we don't mind, just tell us where to get in line. We sure do like that fried chicken, Lord. Well, the best, well, there's a benefit to all of this that you might have overlooked and you might have missed. So let me tell you the best part of it all. With, oh, well, there's a benefit to all of this that you might have overlooked and you might have missed. So let me tell you the best part of it all. Each time we go and eat all our fill, why, the chicken stock market goes straight up the hill. And that's why we're always eating down at KFC.
KFC.
We sure do like that fried chicken, Pastor. We sure do like that fried chicken, man. Famous Crispy, we don't mind, just tell us where to get in line. We sure do like that fried chicken, Lord. I say we sure do like that fried chicken, Lord. Amen. It feels good to laugh, don't it? Amen.
Amen.
I felt good singing that song.
We ought to be happy.
We ought to be happy, and as Christians, I feel like it's a little dried up anymore, but... Anyway, I sold that song. Amen. I don't know where it ever ended up, but I sold it. Somebody bought it. I hope it was a chicken franchise. Never got a box of chicken out of it. Never did. Never did. But here's one of the other ones that everybody always wants to hear while you're out at KFC. You got to go down to the Walmart, right? Amen. Let me get a little key change here, and we'll get rolling. We like to have good time. We are not professionals by no means. We just have a good time in the Lord, and we like to do the things that God has called us to do. And God wants you to smile, wants you to laugh, wants you to have a good time. Amen. So here's a one called I Found Jesus Down at Walmart. Is that C? Well, I was looking through my pantry door, and I was needing some things for sure. So I drove down to my favorite store, and Walmart is its name. They have all that you could ever need, everything down from A to Z. A ravioli sold by the case, and all you need in just one plate. There was a man with a big old smile, follow me down each and every aisle. Said Jesus Christ, he can change your style and wash your sins all away. I only came in for some milk and eggs, some bologna and a loaf of bread. What I got was a change of heart when I found Jesus down in Walmart. Now I found Jesus down in Walmart, while pushing on a shopping cart. I found low prices and a brand new start. I found forgiveness and a brand new heart. Now the Cheetos and the Mountain Dew, my the bologna is where I break through. When you're feeling tugging at your heart, he wants to save you at Walmart. Steve, let's hear it. So when your cupboard is getting low, and to the Walmart you decide to go, you'll find low prices and you'll change your soul. and find your sins washed away. There is no need to hide yourself from God, down by the shrimp and Alaskan cod. Oh, when you're feeling tugging at your heart, He wants to save you at Walmart. Now I found Jesus down at Walmart, while pushing on the shopping cart. I found forgiveness and a brand new heart. I found forgiveness and a brand new heart. Down by the Cheetos and the Mountain Dew, by the Bologna is where I prayed through. Oh, when you're feeling tugging at your heart, He wants to save you. All right, Stephen, let's hear it. Feeling tugging at your heart, He wants to save you in Walmart. Amen.
Amen. I want to give a big shout out to my wife and kids and mom and dad and Green Grove Missionary Baptist Church in Albany, Kentucky. If you're near around the area, we'd love to have you come down and be in the Lord's house with us sometime.
Amen.
Thank you for tuning in. As you can see on your TV screen, now there's a prayer line there. We encourage you to call if you've got something on your heart tonight. If you just maybe need to talk to someone, feel free to call. We got folks ready to answer the phone. Just pray that if the Lord has convicted your heart tonight through the Holy Spirit, that you would just call and make it right tonight. Amen.
Praise the Lord. And I'd like to give a shout-out to where I pastor at Barnesburg Baptist Church out on 80-1200 Barnesburg Road. We'd be glad to have you. We are Barnesburgers, and when you come once, you're no longer a guest, so you're our family, and we want to invite you out to go somewhere to church, and we thank God for that. But we're pleased to have you, and want to give a shout-out to Good Samaritan, who does a lot of good help for our community. It's my place of employment, Angie, Bobby, Joe, Amanda, all those wonderful people down there. We love them. And Brother Jordan's going to sing for you. Amen. I want to let him sing this beautiful song. Yes, cries of awoken the master. Listen to the words of the song.
This song's got a lot of meaning to it tonight, and I just pray to seek your heart tonight, friends. Make sure that you, if your time comes due, that you're ready to go and spend eternity in heaven. Amen. Crossing the calm sea with Jesus, the disciples were getting concerned. The wind started violently blowing, He was asleep in the stern. Does He not care that we perish when we're helpless and we're so afraid? But Jesus arose when they called Him and said, "Child, now where is your faith? Oh, you prayed you without any warning, when the storm of your life had begun, seeing no hope in the distance, where you're frightened with nowhere to run. Right now your vessel is filling, thinking that you'll surely drown. Savior, oh, but you know you can't give up now. Oh, you've prayed all night, and you've held on with all your might. Child, your cries have awoken the Master. Oh, he knows your voice. Lift your hands, it's time to rejoice. Child, fast asleep, where the winds are so deadly and the water's so deep. Just try to be patient, cause he'll soon bring peace. Just one word from his voice in all mercy.
You do another one. You want to do another one? A little cry and hold it to the Lord. Most people have bluegrass. We have blues grass. Does that make sense, Steve?
Yeah.
All right. We play a little more bluesy than bluegrass, but it's a bluegrass song in the blues type style, I guess would be the way to say it. But if you are watching tonight and you got a problem, you got an issue, you got something on your mind that's troubling you, and you feel led to call in tonight and let somebody pray for you, pray with you, let us know. I mean, we're pastors, and we'd love to help you out. If you're in the Pulaski County community, come see me. I'd be happy to tell you about the Lord.
Clinton,
if you're in
Wayne.
Clinton and Wayne, come to these guys here. I mean, we'll come meet you. We don't mind a bit. That's what God called us to do, is to be pastors and to be under-shepherds, and we thank God for that. But here's a good old song. If I could, I believe I surely would, stand on that rock where old Moses stood.
Amen. Well, crying holy
to the Lord,
to the Lord,
holy unto the Lord,
crying holy
unto the Lord,
unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord.
If I could, Lord, I surely would
stand on that rock,
that solid rock
where Moses stood.
Well, sinners run and hide your face. Sinners run,
well, sinners run
and hide your face. Sinners run to the rocks,
and those rocks
cry out, Lord, this ain't,
said, Lord, this ain't no hiding place.
So crying
holy unto the Lord,
to the Lord,
holy unto the Lord,
crying
holy unto the Lord,
unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord.
Now if I could, Lord, I surely would stand on that rock,
that solid rock where Moses stood.
Well, Lord, I ain't no stranger now.
No stranger now.
Lord, I ain't,
said, Lord, I ain't
no stranger now.
No stranger now.
Cause I've been introduced to the Father and the Son. Lord, I ain't,
said, Lord, I ain't no stranger now.
We're crying
holy unto the Lord,
unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord,
crying
holy unto the Lord,
unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord.
Now if I could, Lord, I surely,
that solid rock where Moses, go ahead, Steve.
Well, Lord, I ain't,
Lord, I ain't
no sinner now.
No sinner now.
Lord, I ain't.
Said, Lord, I ain't.
No sinner now.
No sinner now.
Crying
holy unto the Lord,
unto the Lord,
holy unto the Lord.
If I could, Lord, I surely would stand on that rock.
That's on the rock where Moses stood.
Well now, if I could, Lord, I surely would stand on that rock. That's on the rock where Moses stood.
Praise the Lord. Good job, Brother Jay. Amen. And certainly thankful to be here with you tonight. It is a good drive. It's getting a lot better. They're starting to put a road from Pulaski County to Beattyville. Used to, they didn't mean much of a road, was they?
No,
we had a ways to get here. It was more like a goat path. But it's getting better. Amen. They've about got a straight highway through there. It's almost like King's Highway or something.
Nice.
Leading you to Beattyville. Amen. Telling you about the good news of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank God for this station. Thank God for godly people. Amen. We live in a world that's a mess. We need more godly people. Somebody to stand up and say enough's enough.
Amen.
And we're sick of it. We're going to serve God whether you like it or not. Amen.
Amen.
I told you I wasn't going to preach, but I feel like saying that, amen. They've tried to suppress us, tried to shut us down, tried to run us out, and the devil's just laughing, kicking back with his feet up on the stool of everybody's do-nothing. But I say tonight we're going to fight the devil, amen. We're going to punch him right in the mouth and send him back to where he came from. The Bible says one day we're going to go home. If we know Jesus Christ, our personal Lord and Savior, there's a place called heaven. I like to say that I call it home, amen. Sweet, sweet Beulah Land, amen. I got to sing that song, Brother Jay. Let's do that, Brother Steve.
Yeah, let's do that.
Let's do that song.
Let's do that.
Ooh, praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I'm kind of home, sick for a country to which I've never been before. No sad goodbyes will there be spoken, for time won't matter. Someday on thee I'll stand, and there my home shall be eternal. Beulah Land,
sweet Beulah,
I'm looking out over across that old river to where my fate's gonna end inside. Lord, there's just a few more days to labor, and then I'll take my heavenly flight. Beulah Land, I'm longing for you, and someday on thee I'll stand. There my home shall be eternal. Beulah Land, over across that old river
to where my faith's gonna end inside. There's just a few more days to labor, and then I'll take my heavenly flight. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Beulah land, I'm longing for you, and someday on thee I'll stand, and there my home shall be eternal. Beulah land, sweet Beulah land. Well, guys, our time has come and gone. For all the wonderful times that we've had here at WLJC, we want to thank you for those many years and many opportunities to be able to come and serve the Lord with you, to come into your homes. We invite you to listen to this song, and I'm going to step over here between these two guys. I love these guys. Amen. They're my brothers in Christ. You stay right there, brother. I'm going to go right around you. Amen. I know this is not probably the most professional thing to do, but you know what? I believe God overlooks those type of things. I believe if you put God in a box, you know, that's what a lot of churches want to do nowadays. They want to put God in a box. They want to let God have liberty. Amen. Let him have freedom in the church. Amen, Brother Steve. I think we ought to let God have a little freedom. And I want to be free for just a minute because I want to sing you this song. I want you to listen to the words of this song here. It's called The Apple Tree Story. We've sung it 1,000, I'd say over 1,000 times. Probably 10,000 times. Amen. But we're going to sing this one for you, and I want to do a little recitation that I absolutely love this song, and I thank God for it because it tells the story of how you can be saved tonight. I've wandered far away from God. Now I'm coming back home. The path of sin too long, Lord, I've trod. Lord, I'm coming home. Sing it with me, fellas. Coming home, coming home. Nevermore to roam. Open wide thine arms of love. Lord, I'm coming home. Well, not long ago, a preacher had closed out a revival, and he boarded the train to start on his journey home, and he sat down beside a young man, and while making some comment about the weather, the young man didn't answer him, and they rode on in silence. Well, in a few moments, the preacher heard the young man break out into sobs. He said, "Son, I'm a minister. I'd love to help you in some way if I could." He said, "Yes, preacher, I've got to talk to somebody. You see, about 6 years ago, I'd grown so wicked and went so far as to strike my dad with my fist. My daddy told me, said, 'Son, you're worrying me and your poor mother to death, and you're going to have to leave home.' And that's what I did, preacher. I left home. I've lived an awful life. But about 3 weeks ago, I knelt down at an old-fashioned altar, and the Lord gloriously saved this old sinner boy's soul. And the first thing I thought of was my mom and daddy back home, and how I'd love to get to see them just one more time. So I sat down, and I penned them a letter, and I told them I'd be on this train. If they wanted me to get off, I would." Well, it kind of confused the preacher a little bit, and he said, "Son, just how are you going to know that your parents have forgiven you?" He said, "You see, preacher, all my life we've lived in a broken-down shack by these railroad tracks. But out back stands a big old apple tree. And I told them they could find it in their heart to forgive me. Just have one little white flag hanging in that tree and I'd get off." As the train rounded the next corner, the young man broke out into sobs again. Preacher said, "Son, what's the matter?" He said, "Preacher, I'm almost home and I can't bear to look. Almost home, preacher, and I can't bear to look." The preacher said, "Son, trade me spots and I'll be your eyes." He wiped away the frost from the windowsill, and as that last boxcar pulled into the train station, a great big old smile came over that preacher's face. He said, "Son, you don't have a thing in this world to worry about. Why, it looks like that old apple tree's in full bloom. Why, there's white flags hanging all over it from top to bottom, and that's not all. Down under it stands your dear old mom and daddy. They've not only got white flags waving it, they've got a great big old white bed sheet waving saying, come on home, son. Come on home, son. And you know what? Today, it's 2021. And God is still in the saving business. God is still moving and still working, and he's working in somebody right now. How awesome and how amazing would it be for you to come home tonight, that Jesus stands with his arms outstretched waiting for you, saying, come on home, my child, before it's everlasting too late. I promise you that time is running out and that it is fleeting, and that one day, as it was in the days of Noah, when the door was shut, it was shut. Nobody else was saved. And one day that day is coming. No matter how wicked you've been, no matter how much wrong you've done, maybe he's speaking to you right now, saying, come on home, son. Come on home, my daughter. Come on home, my child, before it's too late. Come on home.
Coming home. Coming home. Open wide thine arms of love, Lord, I'm coming home.
Guys, we love you. Fall Creek boys love you. God bless you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Great. From the Fall Creek boys tonight, we appreciate your ministry. The heart that you've poured into the people tonight, thank God for that. Got some good news to start off with. I can't imagine anything better than what I've got to share right now. And Sister Margaret, this is going to be an encouragement to you. This is some fruit of your labor, of the many, many nights that you've spent sitting here and sharing the Word of God and praying over the people and allowing this ministry to go forth and just putting in all those hours. It's paying off. You know, the Bible says there's joy in the presence of the angels of God over one that comes to repentance. And tonight we got Rick from London, Kentucky, that's called in and said he wants to thank Sister Margaret. A couple weeks ago, Sister Margaret, you were saying, if you don't have a friend, turn to Jesus. And he decided to do that. He accepted Jesus Christ, and he is asking us tonight to pray for you and to pray for his family. Said he really enjoyed the singers tonight, so appreciate that. Appreciate the encouragement for them. But brother, more than anything, Brother Rick, we're glad that you got saved. Glad that those words that Sister Margaret shared with you was able to touch your heart, and your life is never going to be the same. So thank God for that. We're going to pray for you tonight. I also had from Breathitt County, Johnny and Edith Johnson called in $100 tonight to pledge to the station in honor of the Fall Creek boys. So we appreciate that support for the station. And I'll read through as many of these as I can before we have prayer over these tonight. May not get to all of them, but we're going to pray for all of you regardless. But anyway, we got from Bourbon County, someone with a shoulder problem. From Casey County, we're going to pray for Brother Boyd tonight who's dealing with cancer. Having a bad day today, so we pray that God will touch you and give you some strength. A person from Frankfort talks about watching WLJC all the time and needs prayer, so we'll pray for you, brother. Donald from Pulaski County praying for mom and dad to be sent a song. What a day that will be. Well, they've come and gone with the singing, but we'll just dedicate the whole service to them tonight. This is a husband from Clay County calling in, asking us to pray for his wife. She is very sick. We'll do that. Sharon got a serious sinus infection. Here's a lady calling in for her sister-in-law. Says she needs prayers for depression, and the family needs salvation. Very serious request, so we'll remember that tonight. All these, any requests, God is concerned about them, and they're all serious. We got Linda from Law County needing prayer tonight. A brother from Casey County, not well, needs strength in the emergency room with blood clots, so we pray that everything turns out okay there. Here's somebody that's got a grandfather in the VA hospital needing the Lord's touch, so we'll pray for them tonight. We have from Perry County, someone in need of prayer in the hospital. They're running tests trying to figure out what's going on. We'll pray that can all be resolved as well. call coming in from Williamsburg, from Crystal, wanting us to pray for her 13-year-old daughter. We most certainly will do that. And like I said, I'm not going to get through all these, and we're going to go ahead and pray over them. But as you can see, all these are very serious to the people that whose lives are represented right here. And these are all prayer requests. So we want to take the time tonight to anoint these and ask God to bless these people, bring strength and healing into their bodies, and do what only He can do. You know, I still believe in the blood of Jesus Christ. I believe it's the blood that saves our souls. I believe it's His, by the stripes that He took, that we are healed, and we can still pray for healing. We can still pray for strength. And tonight, we're going to pray for that healing and strength. And once again, we're just so thankful that Rick, you called in to give that testimony of salvation. What a blessing that is, and I know that's lifted up Sister Margaret's spirits tonight. And so everybody join me to pray over these requests and to pray for Sister Margaret, and then I'm going to leave you with a short scripture, and we'll let you go for tonight. But let's pray over these requests. Heavenly Father, we thank You tonight for the people, Lord Jesus, that's watched this service, God, that has joined us. And I know they've been touched by the singing, by the Word of God. And Lord, there's so many requests here, God, that's been made known. If they felt the need to pick up the phone and call, they're serious to them. And they need Your touch and they need Your help. And tonight, in the mighty name of Jesus, I'm asking that You will strengthen and that You will help each and every one that's called in, even those that didn't have the courage to call in, God, but that's listened and that has cried out to You tonight, Lord. I'm just praying that Your perfect will would be done, God, that You would strengthen them in a supernatural way. And tonight we bind together, we come together as a people, God, and we pray for Sister Margaret and Brother Don. Lord, I pray that You would strengthen her body, God, in supernatural ways, God, that You would restore her health quickly so that she can be here doing what she loves to do, pouring into the kingdom, witnessing to people, testifying of Jesus, and seeing them saved. And I thank You so much for this testimony tonight of this man of the fruit of Sister Margaret's labor. In the mighty name of Jesus, touch them all. Amen. Well, we're about done for. Our time has come and gone for the service tonight. I want to share this passage of Scripture with you from the book of Numbers. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make His face shine upon thee and be gracious unto thee. The Lord lift up His countenance upon thee and give thee peace. That's my prayer for you tonight and from all of us here at the studio of WLJC. May the good Lord bless you and keep you, and I pray you have a wonderful night. God bless you, everybody.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope that you are truly blessed and encouraged every time you watch. This program is made possible by your contribution and support. Would you become a financial partner of the Hour of Harvest with a one-time or monthly offering? You can send your pledges of support to the Hour of Harvest, Post Office Box Y, Bayville, Kentucky, 41311, or visit us online at www.hourofharvest.com. May God bless you.